Hey guys, welcome to my next session. Since you study about pre-order, in-order and post-order, let me give you one very interesting problem based on pre-order, in-order and post-order. Now suppose we have a new traversal scheme, and that traversal scheme is called as, let's suppose, surprise order traversal. So in my surprise order traversal, the nodes are traversed in this fashion: root, left, right, left, root. So we are going to implement this traversal scheme on this tree, right? So what you guys have to do, you have to write a code for this and debug that code, write a recursive tree and tell me what is the output. So how are we going to solve this question? This is very important question and very important for the gate perspective also. So let me write a code for this. So this is my root, right? So when you write a code, so we will first write the function name. Function name is suppose surprise order. This is my function. I am passing root as a parameter to struct node star root. Fine. So if root not equals to null, I am gonna do something. So I am gonna traverse the tree in this fashion. So first thing is coming here is root. So what do you mean by root? Root is a printf. So write a printf statement. Printf percentage %d, comma, root, arrow, in. Fine. And next is left. Left is a recursive call. So write surprise, or I'm just writing S, so just a short form. Surprise order, root, left. Then coming here, right. So again, surprise order, root, right. Then again, it is coming left. So surprise order, root, left. Then again, it's a printf. So again, it is root. So it's a printf. Printf percentage %d, comma, root, arrow, info. Fine. So this is the code for this traversal scheme. So simple. So now let's debug this code and check in what is the answer of this code snippet. So what is the value of root? Root is 100. So 100 not equals to null. Condition is true. Right. So first thing is root info. What is the info of this? Info of this is 10. So first thing is coming is 10. Then coming root left. What is left of 100? Left of 100 is nothing. It is 200. What is right of 100? Right of 100 is nothing, but it is 300. Again, left is coming, left is nothing, but it is 200. And then we are again printing the info part, which is 10. Now we are solving this function 200. So again, 200 not equals to null, condition true. First thing, 200 info. 200 info is 20. So we are printing 20. After that, root left. 200 left is 400. 200 right is null. 200 left is 400. 200 info part is 20. Right. Now we are solving for this 300 function. 300 not equals to condition true, right? So 300 info. 300 info is 30. There is no left. There is no right. There is no left. And info of 300 is 30. Now coming to this 200. So when we are printing 200, see, when you solve this 200, what you were getting? You were getting 20, 400, null, 420, right? Now we will solve for 400. Since 400 not equals to condition true, 400 info is 40. There is no left, there is no right, right? Again, there is no left, info part is 40. So when you solve 400, what we are reaching, we are solving only 40 and 40, rest everything is null. So when you solve this 400, it is 40 and 40. So wherever there is 400, we are coming with conclusion that it is going to print 40 and 40 only. So tell me what is the final output. So what is the final output for this code? The first thing that is getting printed is 10. So we are writing 10. After 10, we are solving this function 200. So when you solve this 200, the first thing that is coming is 20. So after 10, we are printing 20. After 20, we are moving to this function 400. When we are solving 400, what we are getting? We are getting 40 in 40. So when we are getting 40, we are writing 40. 40. When again after this, then 400, 40, 40, right? So again, After this, this 400 is coming, so we are printing again 40. 40. After this, what we are getting? We are getting 20. So we are printing 20. Right? So again, now after that comes 300. So when we solve 300, we are getting 30. 30. Again, we are coming with 400 function. So when we are solving this 400 function, we are getting 20, 40, 40, 40, 40, 20. So write the same thing. 20, 40, 40, 40, 40, 20. After that, we are left with only 10. So this is 10. So this is the final answer. So I'm again repeating. Once you write your code, it's very easy. So 100 not equal condition to 100 info is 10. 100 left is 200. 100 right is 300. 100 left again is 200. 100 info is 20. So we will solve it for 200. 200 info is 20. 200 left is 400. 200 right is null. 200 left is 400. 200 info is 20. Now we are solving for 400. 400 info is 40. 400 left is null. Right is null. Left is null. Info is 40. After that, we are again solving 400. But we will check here when we solve for 400, what we are getting. We are getting 40 and 40. So we will directly write 40 and 40. So when we solve for 300, again info part is 30, there is no left, there is no right, there is no left, again info part is 30. So now we will solve for 200, so when we solve 200, then this thing came, 20, 40, 40, 40, 40, 40, 20, so 20, 40, 40, 40, 40, 20, then finally 10 is the answer, right? So any doubt about that? Okay. Thank you so much.